Hello, hello, my dear friends. Today we're gonna make another one video for the last step to prepare your machine and your electric pedal for sewing. It will be a short video, but we go through the very necessary steps, okay? So if you talk about Kenmore, we need to make sure that we choose the right stitching pattern. Like this wheel, you see, we can move it and we can choose different stitching pattern. Also, when you move this wheel, make sure that your pressing foot and your needle, if you can see it here, needle is up, you see, so if you put this needle, like for example, down and you start changing different position, you can break a needle over there. So before changing patterns stitching, move your needle, make sure your needle is up. See, and better to even to lift up the pressing foot. Okay, so this is small things, but you need to follow this also. Okay, so we choose from this, like this machine, for example, has like five different straight stitching preset, like patterns. So these four, it's just different lengths of stitching. But they're all straight located, like needle. This one, it's also straight stitching, but the needle is side located, like moved a little bit on the left side. Okay, and so we can, usually I use like C, but if you use much thinner fabric, for example, like silk or very thin, like cotton or rayon, you use A, you use B, and D, it's usually used for example, if you make coats or you make like a blanket, something like fabric much thicker and having more like volume. Okay, so if you're talking about Genon over here, it also has like a wheel, so you can choose between different sets of pattern. This machine has only three, so like very tiny, little bit wider and long straight stitching. So this machine is a little bit different. This machine doesn't have preset different lengths, but you can actually choose different lengths. So if you put this wheel, like pattern wheel, on a straight stitching, you can use different lens. So in this video I'm talking only about straight stitching and different sets of this straight stitching pattern, different machine. But in this next video I will talk about different types of you see the zigzag stitching, or it's also called like edge embroidery or edging embroidery. So you see, all the machine, they usually very basic machine, they have it. And also we use zigzag stitching to make button holes. So I will describe this step by step in different videos, so you can make a very good like a manual for your machine as well. Okay, so now we're gonna plug now our pedal, and I will show you how to use the pedal. So now, before we actually go to the pedal, I want to show you. So we prepare our machine. We turn it on. We plug our electric pedal. So let me lift it up, and we choose. I will use C position. Okay. So that. Okay. Now we go to the pedal. So first of all, of course, make sure you have a good shoes. Okay, so when we start stitching, we need to make sure that our heel or your high heel, whatever you use, of course, we usually don't use high heel, but I just want to be beautiful in this video. So we put our heel to the floor. So it's kind of like a driving a car. So the same way. So your heel is kind of like an anchor point, okay, and we just make different speed by pressing the pedal down. So watch, if you like start and I press a little bit and make it down, it's so fast, kind of let it stop, okay? And this way you will be able to actually manipulate your stitching slowly and easy. Sometimes people start sewing like that. This is not correct. You will always do some mistake. It's not such as easy to actually control your speed. Okay, another one mistake people can make. They put their heel and all foot on the pedal and trying to, you know, to sew this way. This is also not so stable position for stitching, so you cannot control the speed very well. So your foot, your heel need to be always on the floor, like an anchor point. So put your pedal in the right position. It will be comfortable for you. Put your heel on the floor. Then you push your pedal slowly, you see, like that. So you can easy manipulate and make the speed what you like. And also when you start sewing, start to like try to make it as slow as you can. So to make it very slow position, like stitching to very like to stop. And again, if you do this exercise, it will be much easier for you to do like good stitching after. So for the stitching over here, so very important, you see this, all this kind of lines over here, it's actually helping you. Like, let me show it over here. You see different lines, like usually they have numbers. Some machine doesn't have numbers, but you can also see the lines. Okay, it's just helping you to make your stitching like straight. So these are your guidelines. Okay, so let's make turns over here. So you need to remember about the first rule. The biggest part of your fabric, of your piece, what you stitch, goes here. And your allowances go here. Do not switch it. Do not try to push your biggest, like your dress or skirt over here and put allowances to this side. This is biggest part, okay? And I saw this mistake a lot. It does not let you to stitch correctly and straight. So the second rule is your hand position. Hands position. So some people trying to do it this way, you see? And that does not let you to actually manipulate fabric well. So always your right, if you're right-handed or left-handed, it doesn't matter. Your right hand goes here, left hand goes here. Okay, so it lets you a lot of, you know, like place for movement, so you can manipulate your fabric if you need it. Okay, so this hand little bit, not like pulling, just make it straight and guide. And this hand also will help you to guide to the line, to your guideline over here. What I was just showing to this like lines here, okay? So I hold it like that and I smoothly start pressing the electric pedal with my foot, okay? And do it like that, you see? And at the end of the stitching, we usually use back stitching, don't forget about that. So we put, each machine has it. This machine is over here, you see? This machine has it over here, like this location. So any machine they have, let's see, any machine has reverse stitching, go back stitching, see? So how it works, you press it down and you keeping it pressed and you start like stitching and your machine will be stitching backward, look. You see, backward. And after I let it go and I stitch it again and go forward. Okay, when you finish, you lift your pressing foot up and look what's happened. Now my needle is up, yeah, you see? But sometimes when you finish your stitching, your needle is down. So when you wanna take your fabric, what you need to do, you need to lift up the pressing foot and also turn your this balance wheel, it's over here, you see this balance wheel, towards yourself, only towards yourself, make sure. And after that, when your needle is upper, that like in the highest position, then you can pull your fabric, you see? And you pull it like about, I would say like maybe 10 inches and you cut it, okay? So for what we do reverse stitching. When we cut, after we finish, like you see, we can cut just straight to the edge. So when you open it, you see, it lock you stitch in place. Like for example, from this side, we didn't do like reverse stitching. If I wanna now to pull them apart, you see, it just ripping apart. So before we finish, I wanna say a few words about thread tension regulator. So, and what it does for your stitching. So I wanna just, first of all, show you, for example, if we lose it, for example, if we make it loose, what is that, to number one, you have this one small mark over here, you put it across of this mark, you see, like zero, or let's say put one, okay? The same set, straight line, straight stitching, okay? Let's redo it a little bit like wider, okay? And now, I don't do it anyhow, like reverse or something. I would just wanna show you how this change your quality of stitching. Look at that now. If you can see, all lower thread, like pulling up the upper thread, like needle thread is a red color, you see, and bobbin thread is a white color. So you can see, it's like pulling it up. What does it mean? That tension of the red thread is very loose. So it does not pull the bobbin thread up enough to make it beautiful stitching like we have here, you see? Here it was balanced very good. This is no good quality. And even if you touch this, like you can see, you can feel the all stitching on this side. And also on this side, you also can see a little bit different. This is like any stitching, like separated. This is a little bit less, but if you cannot see from this side, you will definitely see it from this side. And also what does it do? If you pull it, you will see, you see this little bit loose red thread, you will see it here between two pieces of fabric. Okay, let me do it the next. Let's we pull it all the way up. So usually, you see, each machine they have like middle position, middle numbers. It's like what you usually work within this like three or four position. It's most like working position, but if you put it all the way to number like 9 here, it's the last one, okay? And I will stitch now here. So as you can see now, our needle thread is much more, the tension is much more higher, and they're kind of pulling lower bobbin thread up. You probably cannot see it on the camera, such as big difference here in the quality. But you can see, because it's also it's white with a white color, no, but you can see the small, like, white threads. You can see between this red color. Okay, so to make it shorter and more easy for you to understand. So the, like, number 9 and a higher tension, making the bobbin thread pulled up and more visible on the upper surface. The more loose tension, like number 1, making the needle thread pulled down, like to the bottom, and more visible on the bottom, like we did on this stitching, you see? So, but we usually use, you see, the middle position, like in the center, usually they have some marks on the middle position, like this 3, 4, 5. Usually we go between this marked numbers. Okay, this is all for today. So I really hope this video will help you to understand what are all this control on the top of your machine and help you to operate your machine. And also, please be confident and you can start already trying and stitching, do it like very simple project. So also I want to remind you that I teach online classes and I put the link to my website in the description of this video, as well as other links to my another video on how to thread your machine and how to winding the bobbin for your machine. So, and of course, if you like this video, put a like, subscribe to my channel and put the notification bell so you do not miss my next video. See you soon. Bye-bye.